Good evening, everybody. My name is Fredrick Keith, and this is a brand new podcast, and it's called Straight Talk. I'm going to be your host this evening. My co-host is Mr. Britton Newone Carter.
What up, what up, what up, Fred? What's up, people?
Hey, man, it's good to have you here, brother. It really is. So we're going to jump right into it. You know, this is Black History Month, and
We get 28 days.
Yeah, we get 28 days. You know what I mean? 28 days. They just give us 28 days. You know what I'm saying? You know, you might as well call it Black History. Don't even give a month. Don't even say month. Just Black History for a few days. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, we are going to invest in this podcast. And because it is Black History Month, we want to give y'all a little bit of what we're feeling and what's on our minds. So tonight's subject, tonight's topic, it's a very touchy subject, I think. So we're just going to put it out there. And this is for all the brothers out there, right? Ooh. And for some sisters, too, as well.
Got to give the sisters some.
You got to give the sisters some. You know, got to give the sisters some. So here it is. Have you ever had to deal with a Black woman who may be angry, she may be bitter, right? She's gone through some things, you know, and the father of her children is having a difficult time seeing his kids, you know. This brother may have, you know, he may have gone to penitentiary. He may have been abusive. He may, whatever the case might be, but he's changed. You know what I mean? He's changed and his life is on a straight path now. He wants to be involved in his kids' lives, but she's making it difficult for him to do that, you know, because of that bitterness and that anger that she has, and she's holding on to that. So that's the subject tonight. You know, we want to give our input on that. So what do you think about that, big bro?
I think you're trying to tell my business. You know what I'm saying? Boy, I'm sitting here listening to that, Frederico, and you know, it had me written all over it. You know, I don't know about no other brothers, but but that show sound like me.
Right.
And you know, yeah, I got some thoughts about that. You know, that's something that's like a cancer to African American males today. Mm-hmm. You know, it tends to plague our community, where brothers are met with difficulties and they struggle, and the woman is bitter. Not all women, but a lot of women find themselves bitter at the brother, and they utilize the children, you know, as bargaining chips, you know, or as the whooping stick to penalize that brother for infidelity or for not dealing with her or whatever the problem may be. You know, even for his just going to the penitentiary, having problems, you know, they tend to, you know, use it as a punitive measure towards brothers, you know, and I find it absolutely asinine to do that. Why would you want to, you know, not allow your father of your child, the father of your child, to have a relationship with that child, you know, whether you got one with him or not, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, absolutely.
You know. Yeah, one of the things that I see that happens is that, you know, our women, and, you know, and us Black people as a whole have become too content with allowing the court system to dictate their relationship.
Talk about it, brother.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You gonna tell me, you know, meaning the courts, y'all gonna tell me how, when, and where I can see my Black child, you know what I'm saying? Based on the fact that this woman is mad at me, so I can't see them, you know, unless I play a certain dollar amount or if it's supervised, unsupervised. We're not talking about you doing anything harmful to the child prior to. We're talking about the mere fact that you're not having a relationship with her and she take you to court for child support. Your ass might wind up in the penitentiary. You know what I'm saying? You may stay broke.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? Because if you're spending all your dollars on child support that you couldn't meet in the first place, how are you to survive? It puts you in an adverse situation to where, you know, you're struggling to survive. And us as black men, particularly those that have no marketing skills whatsoever, you know, those that come limited, let me say that, they come limited with resources and, you know, skills that puts them in a better position. You know, what we're doing is we're allowing this system to be the thing that keeps oppressing our black men, you know, and how can a queen not have a king?
Wow, brother, you know, you touched on some areas that you know that I can even identify with. You know what I mean? And you know, you're right. Those punitive measures that women, particularly black women, I mean, let's get real, that they use towards the black man. To me, in my opinion, it only exacerbates the stereotypes that most Caucasian people have about black men. You know, they say we're lazy, we're criminally minded, you know, we can't change. You know, we're the biggest reason that the recidivism rate in penitentiaries, particularly, are at the levels that they are. You know, my thing is, why involve the court system? You know, why involve the court system when we can have sit down and have a conversation? I'm willing, you know, and generally speaking, a lot of black men are willing to have that conversation with the black woman so that we can figure out how do we make this relationship work so that it works for our children. Right. That's the biggest issue. Right. You know, you put the children in the middle of the adversarial relationship that we're having, you know what I mean? And that makes the children bitter.
That's right.
You know,
that's
so right. They go to school, that's right. You know, they go to, you know, outings with their friends and whatever they're doing, and all of that anger and resentment, hurt, and even fear.
That's right.
Begins
that's
to right. play a part in their lives, you
that's
know.
That's right.
And I'm not one to say that it's entirely the black woman's fault. Of course not. I mean, generationally speaking, we have suffered from you know, societal ills that create this distance between us,
right?
You know,
right.
And there was something else you said that really touched my heart. You know, we don't give black men enough credit.
That's right.
We don't give black men enough credit. You know, whether you're working at McDonald's or you have a corporate position. If you are willing to be in your child's life, you know what I mean? I think the court systems should back up. I think the families of that bitter black woman should back up. As long as you're doing what you're supposed to be doing. And I think that the most important thing is spending time with your children.
That's right.
You know, a lot That's of brothers right. are so, not a lot of brothers, but some brothers are so caught up in their own egos that they don't have the time nor the patience to give to their children.
Mm-hmm. You know? That's right. Yeah. That's right. You know, I was sitting here listening to you, and you know, when we talk about the destruction of the black family unit, mm-hmm. you know, the destruction of the black man, black woman, mm-hmm. you know, we have to look at what we buy into.
Mm.
You know, what we allow to have happen to us.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and you're absolutely right. It's not just the black woman. She's just not a bitter black woman. Mm-hmm. There's some historical things that go along with this.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? You know, I'm getting to my man, Willie Lynch. You know what I'm
yes,
saying?
Sir.
See,
yes,
Willie
sir.
Lynch put his game down
yeah,
long time ago. And,
yes,
and we don't take the time to look at what had systematically happened to us over the years, over the many decades.
Mm-hmm.
It's been imprinted in our minds and in the things that we do. Mm-hmm. So, you know, they started separating the black man and the black woman hundreds of years ago.
Yes, sir.
You
yes,
know
sir.
What I'm saying? They started
yes,
making us, you know, the black woman look at us as less than because we were already inferior, correct?
Correct.
You know what I'm saying? So if you gave my black sister, you know what I'm saying, just a little bit more power back then than me, you know what I'm saying, then that's the position that she's going to have so many decades later. And that's what we see now. You know, what we see now in America is that, you know, like you said before, you know, black men are shiftless, you know, lazy, you know what I'm saying? Or we're criminalistic, you know, we do criminogenic behaviors and that type of thing, which is far from the truth. You know what I'm saying? But here it is. You would rather give my queen, and I'm grateful that they do, allow my queens to have positions that you refuse to allow the black man to have. You know, so you keep her at a position of superiority and me at a position of inferiority. You know what I'm saying? When you stop to think about it. So there's no wonder why, you know, they're quick in some cases, in some cases, quick to allow this system to continue to feed their needs, you know, because they've been doing it over and over and over again. And even more so, you know, and I'll be transparent with you. You know, I'm one of those fathers. I mean, this scenario absolutely fit me to a T.
Oh, yes, sir. You know, I can
gratefully that, you know, the women in my life, we grew beyond some things. But I can remember early on, you know, when some things were happening in my life. And, you know, I went to prison. And I get there and I got child support, you know, in tow. And here it is decades later when I'm finally released. And, you know, my sum total over the years was something like $50,000. You know, and I'm like, how do I pay arrearage of $50,000 and stay free?
Wow.
And stay free.
A lot of brothers have had that dilemma, I being one of them.
You know what I'm saying? I didn't have 50 grand to give nobody.
No, sir.
You know what I'm saying?
No, sir.
Fortunately, you know, and you don't miss it. So when I changed tracks and became legitimate and doing some things, of course, I haven't seen an income tax return in years. In years. Now I'm down beyond 7,000. You know, a little bit of south of 7,000. And, you know, and I'm grateful. But let's look at the reality of this thing. Did my kid, did my children get that 50,000? Hell no. They didn't get it. Did she get it? No. No. The government, the state, they got that paper.
They always get it.
You know what I'm saying? They so my point is, while y'all busy being mad at dude, you know what I'm saying? And you think you gonna get some scratch? Hey, listen, you better think twice about that. You'd be better off negotiating the terms of your relationship, you know, with him.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying? Go get somebody from the community. And that's where the community is so important. We got to go get members of our community, elders. You know, we got to go back to the science. We got to go get elders. We got to say, hey, come on, you got to sit down with me and Johnny so we can get this thing together and figure out how we best going to raise our child and take care of our child together. Let's leave this system out of it. So if you want to put a system in it, why not put a system in it that looks more like you?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You hear what I'm saying? Y'all hear what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Get a system that looks more like you, that's more understanding of your plight than not. You know what I'm saying? Because they don't mind letting Kizzy be the one to spank Kunter. You know what I'm saying? They just don't mind.
Well, you hit them over the head, Britton.
So, you know, y'all better get it in order. You know what I mean? We got to stop, you know, being the vehicles that drives, you know, the wedge between our black families. You know what I'm saying? And don't get me wrong. You know what I'm saying? I'm not racist. You know what I'm saying? And then again, I guess I am. Somewhat. You know, I'm pro-black.
Yeah.
I'm pro-black every day. But I love America. I love people. I love people in the world. But I am pro-black. You know what I'm saying? I am for what looks like me. You know what I'm saying? Because we suffered the worst Holocaust in history.
Yes,
and
sir.
This is just one of the key elements. This is just one of the gas chambers, if you would. You know what I'm saying? That they use to stifle us, metaphorically speaking. Just to stifle us, you know what I'm saying? And keep us held hostage. You know what I'm saying? I'd be able to do it with his woman and his babies. And women, please, please, quit getting mad at Day-Day and telling him he can't see his baby.
That's right.
You know
what
I'm saying?
That's right.
Did you hear me? Please quit getting mad at Day-Day. And let the man see his baby.
Let the man see his babies.
You know what I'm saying? Lord have mercy. Because that's the only way that they're going to learn what being a good black man is about. The queens, they look at us, they look at the black fathers, and you know, and don't get mad at them when they go find one that's like his daddy. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Or they go and they pick the wrong guy, so you say. Mm-hmm. What they're doing is they're emulating you in him. Right. They're choosing what you choose.
Right, because they get part of your chromosomes and his. So you know, when you combine the two, you're right. You can't get mad because, you know, children only, they're minor birds. You know what I mean? They mimic what they see. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So, you know, you have to be very, very careful what you say around your children.
That's right.
Because they will emulate it and, you know, before you know it, they're just like, hey, listen, y'all, we're out of time. But listen, this was so engaging. I appreciate my big brother, Britton Newone Carter. And the brother's doing big things, y'all. You got to check him out on YouTube. Keys and Cuffs. What's the other one?
Keys and Cuffs. Hopeless Romantic.
Hopeless Romantic.
You know what I'm saying? My brother, the Devil on Earth.
My big brother, he's an actor. He's a producer. He's a director. He's a writer. And he's also a serious black militant. No, I'm just playing.
I am.
But he is. I am. Hey, listen, y'all. We appreciate you. This has been Straight Talk. Please join us next time.
Straight Talk.
Straight Talk, y'all.
Straight Talk.
Much love. Peace.
Peace.
Put your bad self. Say it louder.